Congratulations, Esther, for correctly guessing what I use to curl my hair. You guys, let's get into this. I use toilet paper rolls along with paper towel rolls. I've been collecting them for a while now, and it's very easy. You start by cutting the toilet paper roll in half and then cutting along the length of the half. And after you do that, you just roll it a little bit more so you can get a nice tight curl and put some tape to secure it in place. And that is literally it, you guys. Very simple. And you get a short roller with the paper towels. I got a nice long roller and I cut these in four. So I started by cutting down the middle and then I cut the halves down the middle as well. And of course, I repeated the entire process. We have a runaway, so I'm gonna cut it first down the length, and I'm going to use my tape to gauge how much I need, and then roll and place the tape on there. What I did learn, however, is that the coffee table is the perfect place to put all your little tape sections and then just roll it up and pull it off. Very easy, guys. These are all of my rollers. All 36 of them. I actually ended up using 26, but I had 36 in total. And let's play around a little bit first with my rings. Lord of the Rings, or should I say Lady. I already put my hair in Bantu knots. I used some leave-in conditioner and we're gonna comb it out and use my Argan Oil Styling Cream by Luxe Organics. It's been a long time and I need to finish this product before it expires. So a little bit on each section of hair, and I'm making rectangular sections so that I can double up when I'm rolling because I don't like too many rollers in my head at once. There's not enough space in there. And I'm wrapping the first section from root to tip. That's what works best for me. Grabbing the second section and wrapping it around also from root to tip in the same direction. One bobby pin is pinned down on the end to make sure the hair doesn't escape, and another on the origin so that the hair doesn't escape there either and cause a tangled mess. I'm repeating the process again, wrapping around, grabbing the next section, wrapping, making a little bit of overlap so that I can transition nicely and I won't have any hair from the first section falling off the roller at the ends and unraveling. And of course, using the bobby pins to pin everything down. This roller, or modified roller, or at home DIY roller, it is a little bit more difficult to use than my regular rollers. Maybe I should have just gone ahead and wrapped the entire roller with tape to make it smoother. Plastic, silicone, all the other types of rollers are so much easier to work with than this. But I got good results, so I'm not complaining. And I'm gonna show you guys now. I'm using a toilet paper roller. And you can see it's shorter than the others, so I can only put one section on there, but it's nice and smooth, and that's all I care about. And I'm going to go ahead and pin this one down as well to make sure it doesn't escape. Usually, and many of you have noticed by now, I use edge control on my ends, but I'm not doing it this time because I didn't know at the time that I rolled my hair where any of my edge controls were. So I didn't do it, and I'm gonna have a few frizzy ends. I'm not too concerned with that because I ended up tying my hair up anyway. If I was keeping my hair down, I would have hunted my edge controls down, but I wasn't. So I was not bothered by that at all. And I'm just wrapping around and making sure I pin it right on the end to get it as smooth as possible, guys, because I don't have edge control to make it smooth. And of course, pinning at the origin to keep everything in place. These are my rollers the next day. This is what they're looking like. And let's go ahead and remove them. Very easy, just take out the bobby pins. And of course, on the first one, that one bobby pin had to be difficult for no reason at all. But it's out now, and we're gonna unravel this one. And this is what it looks like. Very curly side profile. I love it. I love it. I love it. So the Luxe Organics cream did exactly what I wanted it to do, which is make sure my hair dries overnight because it is a little bit dehydrating. So when you use a cream like that, you have to make sure you use a leave-in conditioner beforehand, which is what I did. And I didn't use any oil this time because I didn't want product buildup, because I'm washing my hair like 3 days after doing this, so there's no need at all for me to have any excess product in my hair. Only what can get the job done. And my curls, guys, they came out juicier than expected. I mean, look at that. Look at that. Looks really, really, really good. Really good. Yes. Very good. Awesome. All right, let's move on and remove the rest of these rollers. Interestingly enough, Jasmine thought that I curled my hair with shower hooks. I don't know how I could pull that off, but I'm very intrigued by that guess. And now I want to try it. I don't know, guys. Like, I want to try it. I want to try curling my hair with shower hooks. So if you see me curling my hair with anything odd in the future, which I will, all you need to do is blame my subscribers, okay? And I think I'm almost done here with the removal. But it just looks so good, guys. I'm also actually impressed by the fact that I didn't lose that much hair when I was doing this. I was expecting to have a lot of hair loss. I mean, I had a few strands here or there, like maybe like 10 in total. I'm not kidding. But I thought it was gonna eat up my hair for some reason. It did not. And I like this. I do. It looks great, guys. It's juicy. You know, it's yummy. And we are going to separate these curls so that you can see how they look when they're down. And then I'm gonna tie them up. But take a look at this close-up. It is yummy. It is very yummy. I think I did okay. For heatless curls, I think I did a pretty good job on my hair, because you guys know how kinky my hair gets. So let's go ahead and separate these curls. I'm separating them in half, and then I'll separate them again, at least in 3 or 4 sections per roller, so I can have a little bit of volume. I'm not too concerned with lasting definition, because lately we've had a lot of rain, so I'm not even troubling myself with having perfect curls at the end of this tutorial, because the rain is gonna take care of that, and it did take care of that. So I think maybe in May it's gonna be a little bit better and I'll be doing more lasting roller sets, but right now I'm not too concerned with that because the rain is just disrespectful these days. So let's separate and separate and separate until you see, like, you will literally see my hair is going to get a little bit more voluminous. And here we are. It already looks better, right? Okay, so let's separate one more time here in the front. I think I got 3 sections out of this one. And just twirl around, because again, I didn't use any oil, which I should have. It would have made my hair look a lot more vibrant, and it would have been easier for me to separate without causing frizz. But I didn't want the buildup. I want to have an easy time washing my hair, so I'm limiting certain things and testing things out with my hair so I can use as little product as possible and I can have happy hair that doesn't feel weighed down at any given time. It's a process, but I'm gonna get my order of operations down at some point. So this is what we're looking like, guys. My hair, it looks great. It looks like I did my hair with spoolies, bantu knots, perm rods, who knows? It just looks like a regular roller set. So that's the afro, guys, the curly afro. What do you think of this? Would you try this? And I know I got chastised in the past because I did heatless broke girl curls, but I mean, I'm just saying, guys, we don't have the money to buy rollers right now. So would you try this? Instead of spending money on rollers, would you try this? Okay, I'm not gonna ask that anymore. But I still have the rolls. They're not bad. They still look brand new, so I could use them again. I still have the Keurig cup curlers too. I have a lot of stuff that I use. I still have the straws from the 1000 straw sets, and I still have the red perm rods from the 400 rod set. So I may use these again. I actually did a video using Swirly Curly's products, the snappies, the scrunchies, and the headband. Make sure you check that out, but I'm gonna give you a little snippet of that video so you can see the hair and how I tie it up in different styles. You can pick what style you prefer and learn a little something about quick and easy 30-second hairstyles, okay? Thank you guys so much for watching. As always, I will talk to you later. And until then, take care of yourselves and your families. Bye!